Hi, today on Jay's Tech Tips, we're going to talk about cylinder wall cleanliness during assembly. Cylinder rings, we're going to show a little filing demonstration and how you should handle them during the build of your engine. So this block has been jet washed and it's been hand washed with a bristle brush and detergent soap. So when you look at the bore, there's nothing really measurable on the bore as far as dirt or grime or anything, but the cylinder wall is full of very small peaks and valleys that will trap things during the machining process, and you're going to need to want to scrub those out by hand with a lint-free towel and some automatic transmission fluid. You can just put some ATF on this towel here and just get to wiping it out. For you D-series guys that have really small bores, you're going to need to get some small hands, but as you can see, it picks up quite a bit of dirt right out of the bore. Now, this process doesn't really go quickly. You may have to go over it three or four times or more to really get the debris and stuff that's been in the machine shop out of it. But again, you just use this transmission fluid and put a little bit on this rag and then just keep wiping it out until the towel's not turning black. And then you know that you've got it all out. So just keep scrubbing and scrubbing and scrubbing until the bore is clean enough, and that'll keep the new ring set from being contaminated after you're done assembling your engine. During the installation of your rings, you're gonna need to know a few things and have a few tools. This is a real basic, inexpensive ring file, basic, inexpensive ring pliers, and again, the lint-free towels that you're gonna use, because even though they're clean, again, whenever you wipe them off, you'll get a decent amount of dirt. It's just part of the deal. So everything needs to be cleaned multiple times. The ring is a pretty sensitive device. This is just one that we've file fit for this 2JZ. This is just a spare I have laying around. I've seen people wrestle these onto the pistons with a lot of this twisting motion. This is not good. I'm not gonna use this ring in anything, so it's okay that I'm pulling around on it. But if you try to spread this thing open by hand and walk it onto the piston, it almost certainly will not go back to its original shape. You just get these cheap ring pliers and spread the ring open gently and slide it onto the piston. The other thing that I do is I have a little jeweler's file, and basically you can just take the tip of your finger and walk it around the edge of the ring. You want to just knock off any sharp edges with the file, and it's just a real gentle motion of moving the ring in the file in small increments until you meet your target clearance. And then you can square it up in the bore with your piston if you don't have a ring squaring tool. So once you've got the ring square in the bore, just go ahead and put your feeler gauge in when you've met your target gap, and that's really all there is to it. You want to make sure that the ring is deburred properly and that you are not manhandling the rings around, because that won't work out for you. Hope you enjoy these little bits of information. If you'd like to subscribe, you can click the link below. We'll be doing more of these moving forward and some other stuff that we do here at Real Street.